Dear children, good morning everybody. I think all of you doing well. Today we have to complete the last part of first lesson, and I am going to start second lesson also today itself. Before that, I inform you, get ready for a unit test. Unit test on first lesson. I will conduct it next week. Look here. This is the map of Maratha Kingdom. What are the special geographical features of Maratha? The Vindhya, Satpura mountain ranges and the Narmada Tapti rivers separated the Maratha from the nearby region. It gave natural protection to the kingdom, and Marathi language and literature instilled a sense of unity among them. Shivaji was the major ruler of Maratha kingdom. He adopted the title Chhatrapati. Pune was the capital of Maratha. Dear student, with Maratha kingdom, the lesson is ended here. Take down the answers in your notebook. Now you take down this chart in your notebook. Dear children, this is your second chapter. Medieval India, Society, Resource and Trade. The description given above is taken from Babur's book, Babarnama. What is a travelogue? A travelogue is an illustration of a traveler about a place. Tell with me. A travelogue is an illustration of a traveler about a place. What is the importance of a travelogue? The travelogue gives much important information about the place, ruler, administration, prosperity, etc. Here you can see a travelogue of Al-Biruni. He reached India from Central Asia. Al-Biruni from Central Asia. What are the occupation and taxes mentioned in this travelogue? Agriculture. In this period, there was a plenty of cultivable land in India that was kept uncultivable. Those who first cultivate in such land were granted its ownership. The hardworking farmers tried to win the ownership of such land. Let us see the steps taken by the rulers for the progress of agriculture. Arranged irrigation facilities, supplied seeds, granted tax relaxation. In the medieval period, officers were given land as wages. This system was known as Ikta during the Sultanate. And Jagirdari during the Mughal period. In addition to agriculture, many occupations for making agricultural tools in villages. What might be there? Metal works, bamboo products making textiles, making agricultural tools like plough and watershed, water wheel, making spinning wheel and looms, these are the main occupation developed during this period. Here I conclude my class. I will send you some questions. Please answer it. Comment your name after watching this class. Thank you.